Hi all, in this lecture we will continue the study of iconal equations. In the last lecture we have discussed the iconal equation and how to get the solution of the iconal equation. We know that the iconal equation is of the form ux square plus uy square is equal to n, where n is the n square, where n is the refraction index. So now we consider some particular examples, in which we already told that for solving this characteristic curves, for getting the characteristic curves, we need two initial conditions. And in the last lecture we discussed about, from the first initial condition we obtained from the initial curve. And the second condition, for the second condition, we take the condition that the vector tangent, we provide the vector tangent to the characteristic at the initial point. Or for that purpose, we required the required vector is precisely the gradient of ux and uy of ux comma uy of u. Okay. Appo nammal idinte oru സൈസ് എന്നുള്ളത് നമ്മൾ പറയുന്നത് ഈ എൻ ഓഫ് എക്സ് വൈ തന്നെയാണ്. ആൻഡ് ഫ്രം ദ ഇനീഷ്യൽ കണ്ടീഷൻ വി ക്യാൻ ഫൈൻഡ് ഇറ്റ്സ് പ്രൊജക്ഷൻ അറ്റ് ഈച്ച് പോയിന്റ് ഓഫ് ഗാമ ഇൻ ദി ഡയറക്ഷൻ ടാൻജന്റ് ടു ഗാമ. സോ വി വിൽ കൺസിഡർ ദ എക്സാമ്പിൾ. ദ ഇക്വേഷൻ ഈസ് സോൾവ് ദ ഐക്കോണൽ ഇക്വേഷൻ. For a medium, with a constant refraction, with a constant refraction index, constant refraction index, that is n is equal to some n naught, and initial condition. Here the initial condition is u of x comma 2x equal to 1. So actually the curve gamma is the line, straight line y equal to 2x, on which u equal to, u is a constant, u equal to 1. So this is the Cartesian representation of the initial curve. Okay. And we have already formed the characteristic equations. We have dx by dt is equal to ux, dy by dt equal to uy, and du by dt equal to n square. Here n square is n, n is n naught, so equal to n naught square, which is a constant here. And we have formed that in order to solve this characteristic equations, we have to find the second order ODE, and for solving the second order we have to get two initial conditions is required. So we consider that dx dt, and I am writing the equation. We have formed that d square x by dt square is actually half into what, n square of xy and its derivative with respect to x, and now it is equal to half into n naught square with respect to x, partial derivative of n naught square with respect to x, which is zero. And similarly we will get d square y by dt square is also half into n naught square with respect to y. So this is also equal to zero. So we obtained two initial conditions, two characteristic curves, ordinary second order differential equation such that d square x by dt square equal to 0 and d square y by dt square is also equal to 0. Thus the characteristics are straight lines. We know that by expanding this or integrating this, we will get x of t is as a straight line and y of t equal to straight line, like that. So the characteristics are straight lines and emanating from the line y equal to 2x, and since u is y equal to 2x, since u is constant on such a line, u constant ayathonde enne the gradient of u is orthogonal to it, is orthogonal to it. That is, we can get the second initial condition from that is xt yt. We can consider that xt yt dot ux uy is equal to 0. So we have to find a condition for xt and ut which is orthogonal to the grade u. The second initial condition for the cat, therefore the second initial condition for the characteristic is dx by dt at x t equal to 0 is equal to 2 by root 5 n naught, and dy by dt at t equal to 0 is equal to minus 1 by root 5 n naught. Okay, so we will obtain the initial the characteristic curve in the parametric form as, okay, first we take the condition d square x by dt square is equal to 0. D square x by dt square equal to 0 implies x of dx by dt equal to some constant, let it be some function of s. So x of t comma s is equal to some f1 of s into t plus another constant, that is f2 of s. So this is the first equation and characteristic curve. Now y of ts, similarly we will get y of ts as some g1 of s into t plus g2 of s. And u, we have ut is equal to n naught square. So u is equal to n naught square into t plus some f of s. Now consider the first initial condition, u of x comma 2s is 2x is equal to 1. So the initial curve gamma is x naught of s equal to s, y naught of s equal to 2s, and u naught of s is equal to 1. Okay. So using that we can find x of 0s equal to s, which is equal to, from the characteristic equation, characteristic curve equation, we can write it as f1 of, what was x of ts, f1 of s into 0 plus f2 of s. So this is equal to f2 of s. So we obtain f2 of s as s, and from y of 0s is equal to 2s, we get it as g2 of s. And u equal to n naught square t plus f of s. So 1 is equal to f of s. Therefore, u of t comma s is equal to n naught square t plus 1. And x of t comma s is equal to f1 of s in plus into t plus s. And y of t comma s is equal to some g1 of s into t plus 2s. Now again we have to eliminate some f1 s and g1 of s. For that we are considering the second initial condition, that is dx by dt at 0 and dy by dt equal to dy by dt at 0. That is these conditions star. Okay, so for that, from these equations we can take the derivative. Now x of ts is this one. So what is dx by dt? Dx by dt is with respect to, we are taking the derivative with respect to t. So the term containing s will be, function of s will become 0. And here it will be f1 of s. And we have from the equation star dx by dt at 0 is 2 by root 5. N naught, this is equal to f1 of s. Similarly, we will get g1 of s as dy by dt at t equal to 0. And what was that? Minus 1 by root 5 n naught. So g1 of s is minus root 5 n naught. Therefore, the parametric equations of the characteristic curve are f1 of s is 2 by root 5 n naught into t plus s, and y of ts is minus 1 by root 5 n naught into t plus 2s, and u of ts is equal to n naught square t plus 1. Now we have to change the equations from a parametric form to the Cartesian plane. So for that we have to find the eliminate t in terms of x and y. For that we have x and y, we have these two equations of x of ts and y of ts. In y of ts, the coefficient of s is 2, and so in order to find t, we can eliminate first s from the first two equations, from these equations 1 and 2. So multiplying equation 1 by 2, 2 into equation 1 implies 2x is equal to 2 into 2, 4 by root 5 n naught t plus 2s, and take the second equation as the same, y is equal to minus 1 by root 5 n naught t plus 2s. Now subtracting, we will get left side is 2x minus y, and right side is 5 by root 5. So root 5 n naught t equal to plus 0. So t is equal to what? 2x minus y by root 5 n naught. So substituting that in u is equal to n naught square into t. T is 2x minus y by root 5 into n naught plus 1, which is equal to 1 plus n naught by root 5 into 2x minus y. So u of xy is equal to 1 plus n naught by root 5 into 2x minus y. This is the solution. And this solution has a physical interpretation. That is, in a homogeneous medium, the characteristic curves are the straight lines. In a homogeneous medium, the characteristic curves are straight lines. And an initial planar wavefront propagates in the direction orthogonal. Therefore, all wavefronts are planar. So in this method, we can find the we can solve the particular type of nonlinear iconal equations with some initial condition. From the second initial condition is obtained from the thing that xt comma yt dot the gradient u is equal to 0. Gradient u is orthogonal to the characteristics in the tangent plane. Ux uy equal to 0. Using this relation, we can find the second initial condition, and then substituting, we can solve the equation. Okay, thank you all.